बागीषजुष्वदने लक्ष्मीर्यस्य च वक्षसि यस्यास्ति हृदये संवित् त्वं सिंहमहं भजे। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम राम हरे। प्रायेण देवमुनयो सविमुक्तिकामा मौनं चरन्ति विजनेन प्रार्थनेष्ठा नैतान् विहाय कृपणान् विमुमुक्षयेको नान्यं तदस्य शरणं भ्रमतोऽनुपास्ये। प्रायेण देवमुनयो सविमुक्तिकामा मौनं चरन्ति विजनेन प्रार्थनेष्ठा नैतान् विहाय कृपणान् विमुमुक्षयेको नान्यं तदस्य शरणं भ्रमतोऽनुपास्ये। गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्रीशील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद टोल्ड, एक्चुअली बॉन्डेड सोल दे कैन नॉट फाइंड देयर ओन फॉल्ट, दैट इज द मेन प्रॉब्लम। परमहंस आचार्य गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्रीशील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद टोल्ड, दोज हु आर बॉन्डेड सोल दे कैन नॉट फाइंड देयर ओन फॉल्ट, they cannot discover their own fault, only they can find fault with others. You have some fault, you have some fault, I have no fault. This is the condition of bonded soul, the symptom. But those pure Guru Vaishnava, they are always going to guide me, chide me, threaten me, hey, what you are doing. This is one kind of strong affection. For that he is not going to gain any punishment. Many times I told, Prabhupada speaking, Parashabhava karmani na prasansayat na garhet vishwamekatpakam paswana prakriti purushena cha. Prabhupada used to say very often, Parashabhava karmani na prasansayat na garhet. Don't try to praise somebody or don't try to find fault with somebody. It is dangerous for you. In bonded condition is very dangerous. But when Sadhguru Vaishnava want to speak something to rectify me, that for that it is not criticism. Guru Vaishnava when speaking very heavily against me, it is not actually criticism. Actually it is the duty of Guru Vaishnava to speak that way. It is the duty of Guru Vaishnava to speak that way. If he is not going to discharge his own duty properly, then disciple going to hell. Disciple cannot. That is the main problem. Actually, Prabhupada speaking, why Prabhupada speaking, parasabhava karma ino pasum sadhva karha. Don't try to praise anybody, don't try to speak anything against him also. Why? Praising is good. I cannot criticize, but praising, Prabhupada, no, is also dangerous. Because whenever your mind is busy with that particular thing, I mean to praise somebody bonded soul, to praise somebody bonded soul, to criticize somebody bonded soul, then you are concentrating on that factor. You will have to concentrate on this factor, otherwise how you can praise him or criticize him? In that time, that is a big problem. That time is a big problem for you. Then you can develop some, you know, big problem. So, because he is bonded, for bonded soul, you cannot praise, you cannot speak against any bonded soul, nothing, because they are bonded soul. If you are going to concentrate, you can go down, big problem. But actually Prahlad Maharaj is Guru Varga, you already know. Prahlad Maharaj is Guru Varga. Guru Varga na? Sanghur Narada Sambhu Kumar Kupilo Manu Prahlado Janaka Bhispa Bhuliravaya Sakiravayam Dada Saite Vijani Madharamam Bhagavatam Bhata Guhyam Vishudhyam Durvadhyam Yatkyatya Amritam Asnute. How you can get nectar? It is written in Bhagavatam, 6th canto, that Sayambhur Narado Sambhu Kumar Kapilo Manu Prahlado Hismo Janako Valir Vayasakir Vayam. 12. They are actually Mahajan. 12 Mahajans specifically is written there. Many times I do explain this point. 12 Mahajans are there. Basically, you will have to stand on this platform, shown by those Guru Varga, I mean Dadas Mahajan. Follow. That doesn't mean I am Gauriya Bhakta, I am not going to follow Rupa Goswami, but Sanatana Goswami, I can follow only. Not there. Common platform. Bhagavad Dharma, common platform, Dadas Mahajan saying, first of all, you have to stand there. After that, on and on, you will have to go ahead. They are the basic. Your Bhagavad Dharma, anyway, you are going to develop yourself. You are going to go ahead in Bhagavad Dharma. So basically, you will have to stand on the common platform, shown by them. Prahlad Maharaj, Vishwa, Bolir, they are all Guru Varga. But that doesn't mean whole life I can follow only Prahlad Maharaj. Not that. It means many things which I cannot get time to explain properly. If time permits, I can speak. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Purva Par Koriya Vichar. Many times I told before, you forget. You cannot remember. That's a big problem. Guru Varga, okay. But after that, those who are Guru Varga coming, or Rupanuga Guru Varga, this, that, I have strong belief on them, I respect them, basically I obey them. But finally, you will have to follow whom? Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Prabhupada, finally. Purva Par Koriya Vichar. Bhagavad Dharma, all Bhagavad Dharma. But Bhagavad Dharma in more fine form going to give rasa tattva, this, that, you have to go up. So Prahlad Maharaj is Guru Bhargo, no problem. And at the same time, to get nectar, it is written, Dado Saite Vijani Dharmam Bhagavatam Bhata. Dharmam Bhagavatam Bhata, Bhata means servant of Yamaraji Maharaj. Yamaraji Maharaj sending, deputing, who? Three servant, Yamaduta. They as well, in front of them. Yamaraji Maharaj speaking. Bolir Vayasukir Bayam. Vayasukir Bayam, including me, all 12 Mahajan. So, you will have to follow them. Dadasaitya Vijanim of Dharmam Bhagavatam Bhata. They are actually knowing the secret tattva of Bhagavat Tattva. Bhagavadji, Bhagavat Tattva. Secrecy of Bhagavat Tattva. Yamaraji Maharaj speaking, we all, 12, knowing the secrecy of Bhagavad Tattva. So what I can do with Bhagavad Tattva? Dado Saite Vijani Dharmam Bhagavatam Bhata. Dado Saite Vijani Dharmam Bhagavatam Bhata. Guhyam, first title giving. Guhyam, it is very, very secret. You cannot buy with money power and man power. Follow. Guhyam Vishuddham. After that, Vishuddho, not Shuddho. Vishuddho means completely pure. Dharmo Paihito Koitava Atta Paramanima Saranam Satam. E Prajito. It's actually Bhagavad Dharma. Guhyam Vishuddham is Prajito. Guhyam Vishuddham Durvadhyam. You cannot understand. So secret things, so you have to enjoy full power of Guru Varga. Otherwise, out of your own proficiency, own power, you cannot understand. You cannot understand. That's why you will have to get full power of Guru Bhargava. Then you can understand. That's why in Upanishad you can find Nayam Atma Pravachaneno Labhyano Madhyano Bahuno Suteno is written. You are learning so many things till you can learn. Nayam Atma Pravachaneno, you are giving so many Pravachan, lecture. Here, hearing so many lectures. Nayam Atma Pravachaneno Bahuno Madhyano Bahuno Suteno. Hearing out of your own very fine brain you have, but still you cannot understand. That's why it is within Guhyam Vishudham Durvada ambiguity, very secret thing, beyond human comprehension. But still it is possible by the mercy of Guru Bhargava. Now today is the Abhirbhav Tithi of Nrisimhadev Bhagavan. Today is the Abhirbhav Tithi of Nrisimhadev Bhagavan. We are going to observe this day. It is written in Hari Bhakti Vilas. If you are going to observe this Nrisimha Chaturdashi, be sure, 100% if you are going to follow properly, then you are going to cut all your problem in the way of your bhajan. Bhaktipat iho kantaka koti ruddho. Be sure. Always remember. Bhaktipat iho kantaka koti ruddho. Aha kajami kajami kimaham karomi. Chaitanya chanda yodhyodhya na kipam karasi. It is written. Bhaktipat iho kantaka koti ruddho. Kalaha kalir valina. Kalaha kalir valina. Kalaha kalir valina. This sloka I speak sometime. And after that is written, Bhaktipat iho kantaka koti ruddho. So each and every step you are going to put in the way of bhajan mark, bhakti, you are going to meet with problem. So actually we will have to pray to Nrisimhadev Bhagavan. Each and every avatar of Supreme Lord has some special duty, a special ground we can understand. Actually the Nrisimhadev avatar is to help us, all those devotees to help us to cut our problem in the way of power. That's the main thing. Nrisimhadev Bhagavan coming this for this reason. Actually Nrisimhadev Bhagavan coming to help Prahlad Maharaj, but to help us all, not only to Prahlad Maharaj. Now actually Prahlad Maharaj is 5 years age, 5 years or old. But still Prahlad Maharaj is Guru. Dhruva Maharaj is 5 years of age. But still Dhruva Maharaj is Guru. We'll have to understand. Now actually Hiranyakasipu, the father of Prahlad, apparently. Who is father of whom? Who is mother? Eh? Who is father? Who is mother? We should not speak this way. Atma actually traveling infinity Brahmanda, Chodha Brahmanda is written by infinity, is traveling. And getting some relation with some bonded soul, he became father, mother, brother, wife, husband, this way. So actually, I am bound to speak because it is written there in Bhagavatam. Actually, the Hiranyakasipu is the father of Prahlad Maharaj. So actually, Prahlad Maharaj, 5 years of age, Guru Bhargava, but Hiranyakasipu not at all ready to confess this point. Hiranyakasipu not at all ready to confess that he is Guru. He is 5 years of age. My small boy, he is going to obey me. I can get him under my control all the time. I mean, some enjoying mood, bhog pravritti, enjoying mood. Those who are material people, they have some enjoying mood. Anywhere they look, anything they look, anything they think, they have some enjoying mood. They have some enjoying mood. They want to get control over that object, over those, you know, persons. This way, Prabhupada speaking, bonded soul, whenever they are looking here and there, they always having some enjoying mood. They like to get control over the surrounding situation. That is the main cause of their main cause of their bondage. That is called, that is actually strong bondage. When you have your mood to get control over somebody, something, Prabhupada speaking, it is the main reason for your bondage. That is the main reason. Actually, Prahlad Maharaj is 5 years, but still he is Guru. But Hiranyakashipu not at all ready to confess that he is Guru. Hiranyakashipu, his mood is there, he is my 5 years boy. Is my, he should be my, under my control. This way, Hiranyakashipu always like to show his own power, all the time. Actually, Hiranyakashipu is the meaning of Hiranyakashipu mean, Hiranya mean, gold. Is a, actually, to be frank, gold and Kashipu mean bread. I mean, is a, and secretly we'll have to say Kamini Kanchan. Is a symbol, Hiranyakashipu is the symbol of Kamini Kanchan. All of us, those who are bonded soul, have Hiranyakashipu sitting inside your heart. Always. Hiranyakashipu sitting inside your heart, we are always busy to collect Kamini Kanchan this way. So, we'll have to worship Nishingadeva Bhagavan. Here is glorification so that we can cut our bondage, we can kill the Hiranyakashipu inside our heart, we can go ahead in your bhajan line. That is the main reason for why. That is the main reason for why we observe this Nisunga Chaudhasi. Actually, Sadhan Siddha Prahlad, Nitya Siddha Prahlad, two types of Prahlad. Now actually, this Prahlad, the Sadhan Siddha Prahlad, about that it is written, that Prahlad Maharaj, there's some history is there. You can go. I collect one book, actually, Dadas Mahajan, you can find, in Bengali it is actually there. It was collected from Gauriya. At the time of Prabhupada, Prabhupada published some Dadas Mahajan, I mean 12 Mahajan, their character and their Siddhanta, this, that. I specially collect because I have no time to go through Puran, so many Puran at present. I read already. That day I was speaking, Shukdev Goswami was sent to Janak Maharaj. That thing I can show you there. It is collected from Padma Purana and Skanda Purana, I forget. It is edited by Prabhupada, it is written. Janak Maharaj, too. Janak Maharaj is big tattvabid, giving tattva gyan to Sukadev Goswami first. So, actually, this Hiranyakashipu actually means Kamini Kanchan, and Prahlad Maharaj is coming as son, but actually, he is Mahajan. It is written there, Prahlad Maharaj was the son of some king or landlord, I forget. There's some problem happened, then after that he was fasting. Nisingajodhi, unnecessary, he is not getting any food, anything, water, fasting, unknowingly. And but still he is going to get that result. This Nisingajodhi. They have some details, information about that. So actually Prahlad Maharaj, in this birth we can find Prahlad Maharaj is the disciple of Narad Ji Maharaj. Prahlad Maharaj is the disciple of Narad Ji Maharaj, we can find. How possible? Because when Hiranyakashipu went to forest Mandarachalam to do tapasya, astridian premises, to get more and more power, to get control over the whole universe. He went to Mandarachalam to do tapasya there. At the same that time actually, Kayadhu, the wife of Hiranyakashipu, was pregnant that time. I mean Prahlad Maharaj was there inside womb. That time when Hiranyakashipu gone for tapasya, Indavahara thought that it is a golden opportunity. He is gone for tapasya. A long time he is going for tapasya. This time we can attract and get control over all, you know. This way, Indra Maharaj wanted to attack and get control over this kingdom. that time Kayadhu was arrested by Indra Maharaj, and Indra Maharaj was supposed to go to his own place. But in the meantime, Naraji Maharaj meet in between, in the way. When Naraji Maharaj meeting, the Maharaj saying, "Oh, why you are catching his wife of Hiranyakasipu? You should not catch him. It's not good." Then Indra Maharaj speaking, "I am not going to do anything. Actually, Hiranyakasipu is there, his virya, his power is there inside the womb of this Kayadhu. So I can take her there in my place, and when that baby come out of womb, then I can let her go. Not I'm going to do any harm." "No, you cannot catch. Don't catch." "Why?" "Actually, Naraji Maharaj speaking, actually, big Ma Bhagavat, Prahlad Maharaj is there inside room. Prahlad Maharaj is there inside room, his Mahabhagavat, Ananta Anushar, so he cannot catch, his big devotee." "Oh, really?" "Yes." Then Indra Maharaj leave, Kayadhu, then Indra Maharaj leave and gone. Then actually, this Naraji Maharaj taking that Kayadhu to his own place. There, Kayadhu praying to Naraji Maharaj, "You bless me so that I can keep birth to this baby only when my husband come back, not before that." "Okay, no problem." So in the meantime, Naraji Maharaj went on speaking all Bhagavad Katha, Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan, in front of Kayadhu. Kayadhu mother hearing Harikatha, but Kayadhu mother cannot remember. Follow, fickle mind, cannot remember, no stability of mind. But Prahlad Maharaj is there inside room. Actually, Prahlad Maharaj hearing all Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan and remembering. A special power is there with Prahlad Maharaj. So Prahlad Maharaj can remember inside womb, Prahlad Maharaj hearing all Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan, he become powerful so much. After that, actually, in the meantime, actually, Hiranyakasipu come back, that Prahlad Maharaj took birth. Actually, Prahlad, Anulad, Sanglad, four brothers actually, this way, four brothers. So Prahlad Maharaj's speciality is there with Prahlad Maharaj. So Hiranyakasipu wanted to give proper teachings to the small boy so that he can become Pandit, Jnani. But they are Asura. For them, knowledge is different. Their knowledge, actually, we, in Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan, we know knowledge means Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan. But they are Asur. For them, in Dharma, Artha, Kam, Moksha. Moksha is not even Moksha. Dharma, Artha and Kam. Dharma means to get something. Pious activities, out of that you are going to get some power. Dharma. They are not going to follow Bhagavad Dharma. Follow. Dharma means ordinary je dharma, they are going to follow this thing. Because Bhagavad Dharma means Bhagavad Tattva Atma Dharma. By Hiranyakasipu actually not going to follow it. Hiranyakasipu going to follow actually ordinary general dharma. Deva Dharma, Manu Dharma, Raj Dharma. Actually, they are going to follow this way. Not Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan. You can remember from Bhagavad, I quote this sloka, actually, Gokarna Ji Maharaj speaking in front of Atmadev Ji, Dharmam bhajasya satatam tajaloko dharman. Dharmam bhajasya satatam tajaloko dharman. General dharma, I mean, which is not Atma dharma, that Deva Dharma, Mano Dharma, all you should leave it. And Dharmam Bhajasya Satatam means Bhagavad Dharma, you have to follow Bhagavad Dharma. This way. So Hiranyakasipu going to follow ordinary Dharma, not Bhagavad Dharma. So Dharma means to do some pious activities, Yag Yoga, anything, Yag Yoga, everything. And Dharma, After that he can get some artha, and artha they can utilize for enjoyment. Artha they can use for enjoyment. This much they know. Even mokkha they are less interested. Sometimes they are interested, but they are not that interested about even about moksha. So dharma, artha, kam, moksha, so they are busy with this. So actually, Hiranyakasipu wanted to give, impart some education in such a way so that about economic factor he can grow some knowledge. Economic means arthaniti. Prahlad Maharaj can get some knowledge about economics and about political science, so that how to maintain this. So, Rajdharma, Artha Dharma, this way actually he wanted to give some, impart some lesson to him through two teachers they already engaged. What teacher means? Sondo and Marko, Amarko. They are the two sons of Sukracharya. You can remember I already explained the meaning of Sukracharya. I already give the meaning of Sukracharya. It is written in Bhagavatam, Prabhupada speaking. Sukracharya means Jananacharya. Sukracharya means Jananacharya. And Dakha, already I explained, you know, Dakha means he is efficient in material life, material dealings. Daksha, that's why his name was Daksha. His Daksha means efficient. Efficient means in material dealings. That's why he is. Jag, Joggo, this, the material thing is very. Not in bhakti. Follow? So here actually Sukracharya means Jananacharya. He is busy with this material body and mind. Sukracharya. Jananacharya. How to give birth to, you know, material people, material knowledge. This is the conception. So Sukracharya, his son, we cannot expect. His son can be a Mahabhagavat. We cannot expect because he is teaching this way. Now actually, Hiranyakasipu sending this baby, I mean small boy, Prahlad Maharaj to their school. Where? Patsala. Patsala means school, village school, actually, Gurukul, there. Sondo and Marko, they are giving lesson to him all the time. But Prahlad Maharaj anyway not going to accept this kind of lesson. They are giving lesson to him, but Prahlad Maharaj hearing, actually with humble mood, he is not going to give any protest note against them, because my father sent me here, not speaking anything against them, whatever they are teaching, Prahlad Maharaj hearing, but from heart Prahlad Maharaj knowing that I should not accept this one. I should not accept, because I already know Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan, my Gurudev is Narad Muni. This way, they are giving lesson to him. But one day, actually, they thought, for a long time we are giving lesson to him. So let us take Prahlad Maharaj in front of Hiranyakasipu so that Hiranyakasipu can test what kind of lesson we are giving to him. That should be tested by the king. Then they are taking Prahlad Maharaj in front of whom? In front of Hiranyakasipu. And speaking, Rajan, for a long time you are giving lesson to him. So now, by now I think he is very, very worse in different, you know, economics, this, that, Rajtantra, political science. I think you can test him. Then Hiranyakasipu taking this boy in lap and kiss him with affection, strong affection, and started speaking, my son, what kind of education we have received from your Gurukul, I like to test you. So, could you please tell something? Because any specific question he is going to put, then he can feel nervous, he cannot give answer. He is actually king, monarch, strong king. I kiss him and saw, my son, what kind of lesson you have received from your Guru, Gurudev? Could you speak something? But you like, okay, fine. Then Prahlad Maharaj looking as if not speaking anything. Prahlad Maharaj started speaking. Tat sadu manneh asura varja dehinam sadasamud bhigna dhiyam sadgrahat itvattopatam gihamandakupam vanam gatah yad harimasrayet. Whenever Hiranyakashipu was speaking this way, could you speak something about nice thing you received from your guru, Gurudev? Prahlad Maharaj said, my Gurudev is actually Narad ji. He is speaking Gurudev. Hiranyakashipu means this Gurudev. Gurudev Atma Tattva Bid is actually Guru. Who can be Guru? Prahlad Maharaj thinking, my father goes, what you learned from your Guru? Prahlad Maharaj said, Atma Tattva Bid. Who is actually Atma Tattva Bid? He is actually Guru. So I should speak the name of Narad ji. But he is not speaking the name. He thinks inside, I learned from Narad ji. So accordingly he is giving his testing in front of Hiranyakashipu. What he is speaking? Tat sadhu manneh asura varja dehinam sada samud bhigna dhiyam sadgruhat itvattopatam gihamandakupam vanam gatah yad harimasrayet. You are asking what you have, what kind of lesson you have received from your Gurudev. So I think this is good. Tat sadhu manneh asura varja dehinam. Tat mane this, I think the best. Tat sadhu manne, sadhu man, good, nice. Tat sadhu manne he asura varja, he is not speaking, oh my father. Prahlad Maharaj is very clever. He is not going to speak father. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, tat sadhu manne he asura varja dehi naam. He asura varja. All asura kula, you are topmost, rajaguna tamaguna. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, but Hiranyakashipu, he is giving so much honor to me. He is giving so much honor to me. He asura varja dehinam. Asura varja means, among asura kul you are topmost. Prahlad Maharaj speaking this way, not speaking father. So, in front of Hiranyakashipu speaking, tat sadhu manne he asura varja dehinam. He asura varja, I think, for those jivas, those who are having some material body, for them, I think it is good if they go away from this material sansar, material family life is like a one well. Well, you know, coop, you know, where you can get water with rope and, you know, pot, get water with wheel. It's called actually coop. This family life is compared with coop, well. Follow? Because here, actually, bonded souls, they cannot find their way out, how to go out. They cannot find. That's why Prahlad Maharaj speaking, tat sadhu manneh asura varja dehinam sada samud bhigna dhiyam asad gruhat. Family life means full of tension. That day I told, somebody speaking, Maharaj, what do you mean by family life? You put all problems in one place, dumping. Andrew, this is called family life. All problems, always you put one place, make one heap. And so this is called sangsara. Sangsara means always problem. No, body problem, mental problem, some society problems, always problem coming. Without problem, you cannot lead your life. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, it is just like Asad Gruhat means when you're sometime if you go to astrologer, my time is very bad, my business is going very bad. Your Saturn is very bad. Saturn. That's why you have to take some very costly Indonil money. You have to take costly prescribe and pokraj you will have to take. And diamond. Sukra is very bad. This is a prescribe. So that you will have to go for stone in market, he is going to spend 80,000 rupees gone with golden cover, everything. Okay. Still problem is not over. This way actually, material people, they are always busy. Follow? They are always busy with material problem. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, when star is going wrong with you, then the problem, effect of star is there. It is 100%. Effect of star is there. Astrology, astronomy, all okay. It's vigyan. When some star is going against you, it's putting pressure on you. But when you are devotee, you should not play your head over that. Hello. When you are devotee, because there is nine star, eh? Nine star, and Krishna is tenth star. So we are under the control of the tenth star Krishna. So who is going to care? Who is Saturn going to do? Or Brihaspati going to do? And Neptune going to do? What problem? We never feel any problem. Eh? This way actually, Prahlad Maharaj speaking for all common people, that tat sadhu manneha usura varja dehinam sada samudvigana dhiya masat gurhat. Asat gurha means very bad. If the star is very bad, then putting you in problem, they feel anxiety, tension all the time. For them, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, I think it is very good if they can go away from this material life, which is just like a well, inside well. You can remember, Prabhupada's writing one Upadesha Upakhan, one story. Through story, Prabhupada going to give some lesson to everyone. One day, one frog somehow coming out of well, and meeting one elephant. Very small frog. What is that? Big. After the somehow, he again jump into well and go. Meet with mother. Mother, I keep big entity there outside. How much big? Maybe this size? No, big. This size, maybe. Yes, you know, keep getting air inside and, you know, pumping body. After that, Prabhupada speaking, the mother burst. So material people, out of their education, out of their, you know, money power, they are always expressions of vanity, false. I am big, more than you. This way always. It's a must. You cannot go out. If you are like Janak Maharaj, if you are like Yudhishthira Maharaj, it's rare. Some effect must be there. Because if you can follow your Guru Varga properly, then you are going to cut this problem. Otherwise, 100% you can cut if you are following your Paramahansa Gurudev in total. So in this way, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, actually, tat sadhu manneha usura varja dehinam sada samudvigna diya masat gurhat hitva tupadam gihamanda kupam. This blind well. Blind well means there is no water available in the well. So only methane gas. You know methane gas? Methane gas is there, very dangerous. So you have to leave and go to forest and concentrate unto the meditate unto the lotus feet of Hari. Hitva attupatam, attupatam means it is like suicidal squad. Prahladma speaking, if you are going to live your life in this family life without any reason, without any bhajan, it is one kind of suicide. Prahladma says, hitva attupatam, attupatam means suicide. Hitva attupatam, grihamanda kupam. A griha is one kind of well, kua. Where is Gyamandaku, andakupam means there is no water, is not available. Water is not available. Blind well. Where Devjani was thrown by Sarmishta, you can know. Devjani, Sukracharya's daughter, was thrown by the friend, by her friend, into that well. That case I already speak in Bhagavatam. So actually, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, that Jivatma going to leave this material body, material sansar, and go and meditate on the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, I think it is good. This way Prahlad Maharaj is going to speak the absolute truth. But Hiranyakashipu become very angry. Hey, what are you speaking? Because he is speaking all about Hari Bhakti. Prahlad Maharaj became very angry. Why are you speaking this way? He is supposed to speak some material thing, I mean economics, this, that. Why is speaking this way? About devotion, he is speaking. Hiranyakashipu become very angry and call, hey, what you are teaching to them? Teaching to my son? What, Rajan? But they are speaking about bhakti. They are speaking about bhakti. Huh? You teach? No. We never teach. We never teach this way. Where from there he is learning this, we don't know, actually. Then after that, after some interrogation, Prahlad Maharaj was left. Prahlad Maharaj then left by father. Then Prahlad Maharaj again. Prahlad Maharaj then again taking a small, Prahlad Maharaj is going to again to that Gurukul with two teachers, Sandhya Namarka. With Sandhya Namarka is going back. Now here in this sloka is very important thing, you will have to think twice. Why Prahlad Maharaj giving advisors to go to forest and concentrate in Hari Bhajan? Meditate on Hari Bhajan. What is the reason? Whereas we cannot expect this kind of Siddhanta. Our Guru Varga never teach us this way. Our Guru Varga never teach us this way. Huh? So what do you mean? A jungle? Go to forest? Actually, Krishna in front of Uddhavji Maharaj speaking the meaning of this sloka actually. Prahlad Maharaj mean what Prahlad Maharaj wanted to mean properly. We think Prahlad Maharaj giving us advice to go to forest. But in front of Uddhavji Maharaj, Krishna Bhagavan speaking clearly, what do you mean by forest? Jungle. What do you mean by banam tu sattikam vasam? Rajasam gram uchchate, tvamasam tu duta sadanam, man nikatanam stu nirgunam. Krishna Bhagavan speaking to Uddhava, there actually, banam tu sattikam vasam. Banavas means, to go to forest means sattikavas. Sattikavas means to stay with all sadhu santa. Sadhu Santa. So actually Ramji Maharaj going to forest. By in Dandakaranya, Ramji Maharaj always used to stay with all Muni Rishis. Yes, you can find, go through Raman. You can find in Dandakaranya so many Muni Rishis. So Ramchandra Bhagavan, Supreme Lord, he also wanted to stay with all Muni Rishis all around. They like to get some pleasure, the sadhu santa. This is the actual. And actually in 10th canto also you can find actually Brahma also speaking, I like to stay. Sthane sitaha satikatam tanuvang manovhir. Achena? One slok. Sthane sitaha satikatam tanuvang manovhir. Actually, Vishwanath Chakravarti was writing in this sloka, commentary, Sthane Sitaha, Brahma speaking, it means to stay among sadhus, to stay with sadhus. Because with sadhu, if you stay, automatically the topics of Supreme Lord can come. Satang prasangyat mamavirja sangvida bhavanti hitkarnara sayana kataha, you know. Kapilji Maharaj speaking in front of mother, Satang prasangyad mama virja sangvida bhavanti ritkarna rasayanakyataha tajyosanad asu apavarga vatmani sadhya bhakti ratir bhakti ranukramishyati. He is speaking there. So actually, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, it has some inner meaning. Prahlad Maharaj banam tu sattikam vasam. So to stay in forest means to stay with all Sadhu Guru Vaishnava, to hear all about Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan very nicely. This is the actual inner meaning. So now actually, the Sandhya Namarka taking this Prahlad Maharaj Gurukul again back, And in a very solitary place, they are speaking in front of Prahlad. Prahlad, why you are speaking this way in front of your, in front of king? We never teach you this way. We never teach you this way. Where from you are learning? Where from you are learning this thing? This way actually, Prahlad Maharaj speaking so many things actually. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Motir nakishne parato satuva mitho vipadde to giha pratanam adant govir vihatam vishatam tamishvam panaha panaha charvito charvanam. Prahlad Maharaj speaking. From whom you learn? Hiranyakashipu speaking, you learn from your Gurudev this thing? What you learn from Gurudev? They don't know. They know nothing about this Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan. How to learn from them? They have no knowledge about this thing. They have knowledge? No, no knowledge about this thing. So how I can learn from them? So Prahlad Maharaj speaking, though what to speak about? They are not knowing anything about this Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan. So Prahlad Maharaj speaking, what I stole this look? What? Motiruna Krishne Parato Satova. Motiruna Krishne Parato Satova. Mito vipade to giho vratanam. Adanta govir vishatam tamisram. Punaha puno charvito charvananam. Prahlad Maharaj speaking. Motiruna Krishne Parato Satova. Out of your own effort, or by the help of others, you can. Others mean bonded soul, those who are staying with you. That's why Prahlad Maharaj, andha yathande irupaniyamanam teyopi sichatanta murudham nivadya. Motirna kishne paroto satova. Directly or indirectly, anyhow, you are not going to get entry in this very, very nice soft world. Motirna kishne paroto satova. Mitho vipadde to griha pratanam. Those who are griha prata. Griha prata mean? Griha prata mean? The family life, leading family life. To lead this family life, they have taken resolution. Prata, prata means bhav, bhav. Griha prata and sankirtan prata. Prabhupada speaking, usually used to speak this way. Griha medha. Griha Medha and Sankirtan Medha. You understand Hindi also, I think. So Griha Medha and Sankirtan Medha. The more you are going to get Sankirtan Medha, the more you are going to cut Griha Medha. Griha Medha means you are day by day you are developing your tenacity for affinity for family life. It's called actually Griha Medha. And now, if you are doing sadhu sangha, if you are growing your attention, if you are increasing your attention to hear Harikatha, like, you know, you can remember that King Prithu Maharaj speaking. Prithu Maharaj speaking, crying and speaking in front of Supreme Lord. Karna yute samevaraha. I want to get billions of ear. Why? To hear your Harikatha. To hear Prabhu speaking, you try to get some blessing from me. And Prithu Maharaj speaking, what I can? Karna yuta esame varaha. I want to hear Harikatha. I like to develop thousands, you know, billions of years through which. Prithu Maharaj speaking, huh? Prithu Maharaj there. Another such sloka is there, like with Muchukunda. Muchukunda. So this way actually, Motirna Krishna Paraso Satova Mithavipaddeta Grihopatanam. Those who are taking vow for family life, leading family life nicely, enjoy this family life. For them, directly or indirectly, somehow their biasness is so strong, their biasness, somehow they cannot get entry. Big problem. Motirna Krishna Paratu Satoba Mitho Vipadde to Gyabratanam. Because Adanto Govir Vishatam Tamishram. Adanto, they have no controlling over their sense organ and mind. Adanto Govir Vishatam Tamishram. They have no controlling over their sense organ and mind. Because mind is Panchakarmandriya, Panchaganandriya, and a mind is topmost, leader of all. Mind is leader of all. So together with mind is 11 sense organ. 11 is counting. Huh? So Motirna Krishna Paratosuta Mithopipaddedu Gihapatanam Adanta Govir Vishatam Tamishram. Adanta, they have no controlling over their sense organ, and gradually they want to enter into Tamishra, one Naraka. You can remember in 5th canto or in 6th canto there is some definition about Naraka. What different kind of Naraka there? Naraka. Tamishra, Mahatamishra is different kind of Tamishra. Different kind of description about Naraka. It's not false philosophy. Actually it is there. But somebody thinks it's all false. Not that. Jamaraja, you can reach. His distance is there in Noiritkom. South and west. This corner. Southwest corner. Dakshin Paschim. If you go 99,000 kilometers, miles, then you can reach Jamaraja's, you know, where Jamaraja, Sangyamini Puri. His name of the name of this place is Sangyamini Puri. You can go. If you have wrath to fly there, you can go. Sangyamini Puri is down. Actually, west and south in between, corner. Niritkon. It is called Niritkon in Sanskrit. You have to go. 99,000 miles. You can go, you can find. It is there, actually. So, actually, there are actually different kind of Naraka description there. So here it is written, Prahlada speaking, Je Motirna Krishna Paruto Satova Mithobi Paddeta Grihapatanam Adanta Govir Vishatam Tamishram Punaha Punaha Charvita. They can ultimately have no controlling, they are not doing bhajan, gradually they can go down and down to hell. And they are chewing the same enjoyment daily. Prahlada speaking. In family life, same enjoyment, but they like to enjoy this again and again. So, Prahlada Maharaj compare it with, is it? They actually, they already enjoy, but still they are not getting any satisfaction, saturation. Again they want to. About Devjani and Jodu, you know, already this incident is there. Ultimately, Jodu was actually fed up, follow. As the king, name of that king, Burkhetai. Jodhu to his son actually. Jodhu is son of that king. I can remember. So, actually, they are not getting any saturation, satisfaction. So, gradually, it is compared with Adanta Govir Vishantamisham Punaha Punaha Charvita Charvana. Already they are chewing, the same enjoyment they are giving. Again they like to get some. Like one dog for a long time, not taking any food. One dog is very, you know, hungry. Not taking any food. So after a long time he is so hungry, that in a field they find one dry bone, you know, long before he's lying. That dog thought that dry bone is very tasty. He collect that dry bone and in a place he is sitting and chewing that dry bone. But inside that dry bone nothing is there. But the dog thinking, if I chew this dry bone I can get something, some rasa I can get. He is chewing. But the dry bone having some angle, so automatically he is cutting his own throat, this cutting, and own blood coming out. Dog chewing, unnecessary, dry bone. So that time, unnecessarily is chewing, and some rough surface is there, so he's cutting his own, you know, inside mouth, and blood coming, and that dog thinking, oh, so tasty, his own blood coming. Own blood coming, but he thinks, so tasty. He is going on chewing again and again. So this way, Prahlad Maharaj actually speaking, directly or indirectly, they cannot develop this kind of, you know, devotion. Motirnagisa, they cannot get entry into the sweet world. It's impossible for them. This way, Prahlad Maharaj, after that, actually, after some time, Hiranyakasipu wanted to test his own son again. Because what kind of lesson is, let me see. There Hiranyakasipu, in front of Hiranyakasipu, Prahlad Maharaj again came. Because the son of Marko bring them. In front of Hiranyakasipu, Prahlad Maharaj coming again. Same, again he is putting question. Now, by now, what kind of good lesson you have received, I like to know from you. Then after that, Prahlad Maharaj starting speaking about Navavidha Bhakti. Prahlad Maharaj started speaking about Navavidha Bhakti. Because all about nine folds of Bhakti, actually, Prahlad Maharaj learning from Naraji Maharaj. Naraji Maharaj Bhakti Acharya, learning everything, Navavidha Bhakti. So actually in front of Hiranyakasipu is speaking, Savanam, Kirtanam, Vishnusmaranam, Padasevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasyam, Saksham, Atma, Nivedanam. Iti Pungsar Pita Bhaktischet Pungsi Iti 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 Pungsar Pita Bhaktischet Navalakshana Kriyeto Bhagavati Adhyatan Manne Maditamattama Uttamam. Speaking of in front of father, actually, Asura Varja, that actually Sravan, Kirtan, Smaran, Vishnu, Padasevanam, Archanam, Bandhanam, Dasam, Sakshamatma, Nivedanam, this kind of 9 folds of bhakti, Prahlad Maharaj speaking in front of King Hiranyakasipu. I think it is good. Because this kind of 9 folds of bhakti, in Chaitanya Chaitamita it is written, Mahaprabhu speaking, Ekango sade kimba sade bahu ango, nishtha hoite upajaye premettarango. It is written. There are 9 folds of bhakti. If anyway, if we are going to follow 1 fold of bhakti, 1 fold. 9 fold is not possible, 9 fold was possible for? 9 fold of bhakti was only possible for? Ambarish Maharaj. 9 fold of bhakti at a time. 9 fold of bhakti at a time. If you have no time to, if you have no desire to follow 9 fold of bhakti, then you can follow. One fold of bhakti if you can do with great tenacity, then you can come out successful. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, actually, our Mahaprabhu speaking, 1 fold of bhakti, if you can do rightly, with strong affinity, then you can, ekango sade kimba sade bahu ango. Savai mana krishna padar vinda yurva chaṃse vai kunta gunan varanani. It's actually now with the 9 fold of bhakti used to, for Ambarish Maharaj, it was a special case. But there is 9 folds of bhakti, 9 different acharyas you can find in nine folds of savane, Vishnu savane, parikshit abhavad vayyasa kirtane, this kind of 9 fold of bhakti you can find. 9 acharya, 9 fold of bhakti. So this way actually, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, 9 folds of bhakti if you do unto the lotus feet of Vishnu, it's very good. Bhakti Shetlavanakna, Kriyata Bhagavan. If you can do, as actually topmost you can do. Then again, when Hiranyakasipu, hearing this kind of, you know, supporting factor of bhakti, he is speaking again about bhakti. Then again become very angry. He is threatening. He is giving threat to those teachers. Hey, what you are giving lesson, this kind of lesson, useless lesson you are speaking. How my son getting bhakti? How? That two sons actually Sannumarko with shaking, with folded hand. King, believe us. We never teach them. We never teach him this kind of. Then where from is? Maybe some Vaishnav coming in some disguise. Otherwise, why you are developing this kind of bhakti? Huh? He's very afraid. With folded hand speaking in front of king. King, believe us. Believe us, we are not speaking lie. Prahlad, he is getting this kind of lesson itself. Itself he is getting. Where from is? We don't know. We don't know actually. Naisargi ki iyam matirasya rajan. Badati tapasuto esho. Your son speaking this way, it is svabhavik. Svabhavik means spontaneously speaking. We are not giving this kind of lesson, believe us. In that case, Hiranyakasipu will become very angry. Where? You are some teeny boy, you are speaking in front of me. All the 14 world, they are shaking in front of me. If I stand in front of them, and you are speaking very smartly in front of me, how dare you? Hey! Where from you get this kind of lesson? Speak. Where from you are getting power? So smartly you are speaking in front of me? Prahlad is holding it. The power by which you are powerful, by his power, I am also powerful. By whose power? Everybody is powerful. Hey, stop! You are speaking all the big, big tata in front of me. Small boy? Hey? You can remember that day I was speaking this stuff. Jachaktayo vadatam badinam vai vivada sangvada bhuvo bhavanti kurvanti jaisam muhuratmamoham tasmai namananta gunaya bhumane. I am speaking. He is a more omnipresent, present, most powerful personality. He is giving power to us, so you are so teeny soul, you are showing some power. In front of Prahlad, in front of Hiranyakasipu, Prahlad speaking this, hey, Prahlad speaking, Father, actually by his power you are powerful. By whose power I am powerful? He is a mighty Superman. Don't speak that way. Let me see who is going to protect you. He, Kama, he bring his sword, a sword. Sword mean? It was in cap. Kama. I can cut you into pieces. Let me see who is going to protect you. You are speaking big, big thing. Big philosophy you are speaking. Huh? Let me see who is going to protect you now. He opened his own sword from the cap. Okay. I can cut you. Let me see who is going to protect you. Prahlad Maharaj, no tension. Very smartly. Pull your hand. Huh? No tension, because this is the symptom of Mahabhagavad. Those who are Mahabhagavad, they are having this kind of symptom actually. You can remember, Jarabharatji Maharaj, he was put into that, you know, chamber to cut throat in front of Bhadrakali. Now they are going to cut. We showed their, but still, Jarabharat not speaking, why you are catching me, why you are going to cut me, not speaking anything, no complaint. No complaint, nothing. He is there, he is going to cut, he is getting shot. Then Bhadrakali could not resist this kind of, you know, injustice. Coming out from the deity, cut. From the deity, coming out Bhadrakali with actual sword. Now taking the sword from the hand of Vrishalpati. Catch and take the sword and started cutting them. Started cutting them. Started cutting them actually. This is the system. Here Prahlad Maharaj actually, Hiranyakashipu going to cut Prahlad. But Prahlad Maharaj not expressing any tension. But Prahlad Maharaj is over-sanguine. That Prabhu is there, Prabhu can protect me. Prabhu is there, Prabhu is omnipresent. Prabhu can protect me. Then actually, Hiranyakashipu wanted to cut. Then actually, Prahlad Maharaj in front of Prahlad Maharaj is asking, where your Prabhu? You say is omnipresent? You are speaking as omnipresent. Where he is? I can get him inside this pillar? Yes, also he is also inside pillar. Yeah? Inside pillar. Prabhu is there also inside pillar. Also you can find him inside pillar. Then let me see. With his kum on fist. Then that pillar, you know, get ruined. Huh? Destroyed. And from inside that pillar, Hiranyakashipu looking, what kind of animal coming out? Like lion, this kind of. With, oh, Hiranyakashipu watching, one very nice animal, oh my God. One animal coming, but it's not actually animal, half animal, half lion, half man. What is that? I never see this. He is speculating. In the meantime, Nishingadev coming out of that pillar in front of me. Hiranyakashipu speculating, what is that? I never see this kind of thing. With sword in hand, ultimately wanted to cut that animal. I mean, half lion, half animal, Nishingadev. With sword, he jumped. Like one insect, you know, insect sometimes jumping into fire. Sometimes insect, what they know? Glowing fire, very attractive for those sects, special kind of sect, especially at the time of Diwali, you know, Kali Puja, that time they manifest, they come. If there is any bulb, if there is any fire, they're coming, so many, flying, they jump into fire and dry, burn up. Like that, actually, Hiranyakashipu jump without knowing, what is this? We show. After that, actually, what happens? Big fighting took place. Prabhu Nishingadev and Hiranyakashipu. Big fighting with Hiranyakashipu. Actually, Nishingadev having so many weapons in hand. Fighting, big fighting. Ultimately, you can remember, actually, Hiranyakashipu is very clever. When he wanted to get some benediction from old Brahma. Brahma is old man, he does not have sufficient brain, so I can make fool of him. Hey, what benediction? Actually, I like to get control. Nobody make me amar. Nobody can kill me. I like to become immortal, amar. Then Brahma speaking, I myself is not immortal. How I can give you? You can take another benediction. No, I didn't. Then again, Brahma gone. Again, after Asirib, I am speaking about the beginning, okay. I was speaking. After that, again Brahma came. All body, actually his pranavayu, resting in the whole of this bone. In bone marrow, there is marrow inside. Even marrow almost gone. So all skin, all, you know, flesh gone. Only skeleton. Brahma coming cannot find. Under, you know, inside the, you know, one is a sand heap. What?
Ant heap.
There, inside. There. Brahma cannot find. After that, from Kamandul, you know, for water pot, with mantra, when praying, then Hiranyakashipu again getting back the original figure, previous figure. and praying Dostum Dandavat to him. There is Asura, they are also sometimes showing bhakti, but this is not actually bhakti. So after that, in front of Brahma, he is asking, I want to become immortal. Immortal I cannot give. Then Brahma, actually Hiranyakashipu thought, Brahma is old man, I can make fool of him. I can indirectly, I can give this, get this bar, benediction. So this way, Hiranyakashipu wanted to speak, Prabhu, you bless me so that nobody in your creation, nobody in your creation can kill me. Okay, I bless you. Prabhu, no daytime, no night time, nobody can kill me. Yes, I bless you. With no weapons, nobody can kill me with any weapons. Okay, I bless you. This way, Hiranyakashipu wanted to get benediction from Brahma in a very clever, very clever. But actually, Hiranyakashipu don't know that Krishna is there. He can arrange everything. After that, what happens? After that, what happens? Actually, when satisfying all condition, because Nrisimhadev is not a creation of Brahma, not in a daytime, not in evening, not in the daytime, not night time, in the evening time, Nrisimhadev appear. Not inside room, not outside room, it is in veranda. Eh? There Hiranyakashipu was taken by whom? Nrisimhadev. Not with any weapon, with nail. Putting Hiranyakashipu in lap and with nail and a tear or belly. And with antra, I mean those inside intestine, with one mala, garland, with blood everywhere. This way actually, ultimately it is written in Bhagavatam 7th canto, that satyam vidatam nijavitta vasitam vaptim cha sarva bhuteshu. Actually, to prove that my devotee never speak lie, to prove that my devotee never speaking lie, that's why Hiranyakashipu was bound to come out of that pillar, to prove. It is written there in Bhagavatam, satyam vidatam niyabhitta vasitam. One my servant, my devotee is speaking this, so I have to prove it, that I am also here present. Follow, omnipresent Bhagavan. All dust particle you can find, supreme, if you have belief. You can find. Sattam vidasam nijavitta vasitam. Then Hiranyakashipu coming out of that pillar. Now actually, Nrisimhadev Bhagavan putting in lap and tear. Ultimately Hiranyakashipu was, you know, delivered, and you killed because he is touching Hiranyakashipu. Nrisimhadev already touching. Then after that, all demigods and all demigods, they are coming in heaven. From heaven they are coming. They are one by one praying stuti in front of Nrisimhadev Bhagavan. Bolo Nrisimhadev Bhagavan ki jai. In front of Nrisimhadev Bhagavan, they are praying. But the angry attitude of Nrisimhadev, they cannot pacify those demigods, even Brahma, Shankar. They are unable to satisfy Nrisimhadev Bhagavan. He is roaring all the time. Then after that, they thought, we have never seen even Lakshmi Devi not ready to go in front of Nrisimhadev. Even Lakshmi Devi not ready to go. Brahma Shankar not ready to go. After that, Brahma catching Prahlad Maharaj in lap and actually requesting him, Prahlad, for you, actually Prabhu coming. So please, why not you go in front of Nrisimhadev? Prahlad, well, okay. Prahlad Maharaj not fearing. Prahlad Maharaj, a small boy of 5. going very smartly in front of Nisungadev and standing this way. Whenever Prahlad Maharaj going in front of Nisungadev, Nisungadev feeling out of his own affection, great affection. Great affection. Then what happens? Nisungadev putting his hand on the head of Prahlad Maharaj. Nisungadev putting the hand of Nisungadev putting his hand on the head of Prahlad Maharaj. Then Prahlad Maharaj getting full kippa. Prahlad Maharaj started speaking so many sloka. So many, so nice, nice, you can go mad, actually, so nice. Yeah. Actually, the sloka I started with is beginning, this sloka also. Yeah. Actually, prayena deva munayu savi mukti kama maunam charanti vijanena parthanesha naitana vihayo kipanana vimamoksha eko Nanyam dada sasaranam brahmato nupase. Hey Prabhu, you want to give benediction to me? But I already enjoying kripa of your servant, of your bhakta, Naraji Maharaj. If you actually want to give me kripa, first of all you have to deliver those asura bhayas. Where they have no alternative except you. They have no alternative. You will have to do kippa. Because without you, I find nobody here in this place, those who can deliver them. So you have to do kippa. And Prahlad Maharaj already speaking, my mind is very restless. My mind is very restless. Restless. I cannot concentrate my mind for hearing your Harikatha. What slok? That slok? What is the slok? I forget. All the time I am speaking. Actually, I cannot concentrate my mind. I cannot hear your Harikatha very peacefully. Because without your Harikatha, I cannot go to you. Without Harikatha, how I can go to you? But my Harikatha, Naitat manu me tava katha subai kunthanad. Naitat manu me tava katha subai kunthanad. Sampriyate durita duschamasadu tivram. Kama turam harsaso kavayaisanartam. Tasmin katham tava gatim bimisamidina. Tasmin katham tabagatim bimiswamidinaha. Naitat na etat mano me tabakathas vaikuntanat sampriyate durita duschamasadu tibram. Be careful. Split up Sanskrit. Na etat mano me. Me mean? Me? My mind. My mind. Te, me. This kind of word you cannot use in the beginning of Sanskrit language. Me griho is not possible, mamo griho. But te me insights, when you are speaking, inside that you can speak. Te. That's why Prahlad Maharaj is speaking, noitat na etat, noitat mano, my mind, this my mind, material mind. Prahlad Maharaj is speaking this way, noitat mano me tava kathasa vaikunthanat. He vaikuntha, vikunthanat, he vaikunthanat. Naitat na etat mano me tava kathas vaikuntanat sampriyate durito duschat masadu tibram. Very, very wicked my mind is affected with rajatama guna. I am helpless. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, I am helpless. What to do? Na etat mano me tava kathas vaikuntanat sampriyate. I cannot concentrate my mind for hearing your Harikatha. From Sadhguru Vaishnava, Satang Prasangat, because I am very wicked personality. My mind, my heart is, full of Rajatama Guna. How I can consider? And also there is no way except hearing Harikatha, Jadrichaya mat kathado, this sloka. At all, any jivatma when developing curiosity or tenacity to hear Harikatha, then and only then he can get bhakti kripa. Jadrichaya mat kathado, this sloka, this sloka. At all, if any jivatma develops strong attraction for my Harikatha, be sure that is the only way through which he can get free from Maya. Otherwise, there is no way, no entry, no get up, way out. So, Prahlada Maharaj speaking, what speaking actually? Naitad mamo mano me tabakata vaikuntanata sampriyate duritustama sadhu tibram. Duritustama sadhu tibram. Kamaturam harsasoka bhayaishanartam. Kamaturam, I am my mind full of enjoying mood. Anartha. Full of anartha, enjoying mood. Kamaturam harsasoka bhayaishanartam. Tasmin katham tabagatim bimisvami dina. And always sometimes I am laughing, sometimes crying. This is family life. Sometimes laughing, ha ha ha, sometimes crying. This life, harsasoka bhayaishanartam. And I am fearful because material life is all a bayam ditiya vinivishataha sat ishat apatasya viparjas. I have no attention for you. That's why naturally I have ditiya vinivishman is second. There is one tattva. When you are fully established in bhakti, you can find there is one tattva. Why Prahlada Maharaj is not fearful? When Hiranyakashipu opening his sword, still Prahlada Maharaj is very peaceful, smart. Why? He has no tension. He is having full bhakti. You understand? If you have bhakti, then no tension. If you have no bhakti, then Ditya Vinesh, Ditya second Avinivesh. Your attention can draw to Maya, can be drawn. Your attention can be drawn to Maya if you are not concentrated in 100% into Supreme Lord. Automatic. Bhayam ditiyo vinivesha tahasat ishat apetasya viparya asriti. Tan mayaya ato budho avayatvam bhaktaiko esham gurudeva tatma. Is the advice. Be careful of Bhagavatam. Be careful. So Prahlada Maharaj speaking rightly? Prahlada Maharaj speaking right? Prahlada Maharaj speaking, how to go out of this, all this material bondage? Because there is only way out, only way out. That is your Harikatha, but I cannot concentrate in Harikatha. How to go there? Follow? This way actually Prahlada Maharaj going on. Going on, after that Prahlada Maharaj speaking, Prabhu, I don't fear your this fearful figure. I never fear. Your fearful figure, you know, with teeth, this, that. But I don't fear. I never fear. Because I fear this material samsara. I fear this material samsara. I never fear you are this kind of fearful figure. Because I know you are full of affection. You are full of affection. So I never fear. Trastosmi aham kipanabasala dusuhagro samsara chakrakadanad kasatam panitam.
Naham bibhemite ajitoti bhayanakasya jivharko netra bhukuti ravaso grodangsat antas rajah khataja kesharo sankukarnad nirhad abhita digbhad ribhinna nakagrad trasto asmi aham kipanavasalo dusrahogro sansara chakra kadanad krasatam pranitam.
Sansara chakra kadanad, you know, in Gita, when Arjuna wanted to see this Vishwarupa. You can remember. When Arjuna wanted to see that Vishwarupa, Arjuna was puzzled, mad. What I am looking? All Jivatma entering in your mouth and some attached to your teeth, hanging. Oh, fearful figure. Huh? Vishwarupa. You can go through Gita. You must read Gita. Also, you can learn Sanskrit from Gita. Very easy. One you can think and split up. What is mean? This mean? How to build up sentence? Very nice. At the same time, evergreen. Evergreen science. Human science. The evergreen teachings. Gita. They actually, when Arjuna watching, very so dangerous. Oh, Jivatma going. And some hanging in teeth. Oh, stop, stop. I don't like to see this kind of thing. I like to see your that figure, Shyam Sundaram, that figure with two hands. Proceed, proceed, Jagannath. After that, after seeing this Vishwarup, Arjuna gone mad. I like to see your that figure. Proceed, proceed, Jagannath. Stop, stop it. I don't like to see. Follow. This say Prahlad Maharaj. Actually, one by one, Prahlad Maharaj giving so many teachings there, actually. Actually, Prahlad Maharaj speaking to Nishingadev, Nijalavatushto. You are actually Nijalavatushto. Nijalavatushto meaning you are satisfied with yourself. If bonded soul at all going to worship you, it is just like when somebody putting mirror in front of him and looking same, smiling, smiling. Is this figure in mirror, you can say same thing. Follow? So one by one we have to go through this kind of nice in front of Nrisimhadev is speaking. But before I forget to speak something, what he was speaking in front of? Asura Valaka, you can remember. Previously, I should speak. It is after Nrisimhadev is the avatar already done. Now, Prahlad Maharaj speaking in front of Nrisimhadev. But in front of Asura Valaka there in school, not now, before. When he was there in Gurukul. That's why, that time all small boys, I mean friends, Asura Valaka, they don't want to play. They want to stay in front of Prahlad Maharaj. They want to stay in front of Prahlad Maharaj, hear something important. They are small boys, they are supposed to play. But they are still, they live playing. They don't like to be, you speak something. They, when Sanda and Amarka, Gurudev, not there, then the small boys live playing and sitting in front of Prahlad, hearing. That time, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, all very important thing. Very important thing. What that?
Sukham indriyakam daitya deho yogena daivat sarvatra labhate yasmad yatha duksham ajatnataha. Sukham indriyakam daitya deho yogena daivat sarvatra labhate yasmad yatha duksham ajatnataha.
Hey, Asura Valak, Asura Vayas, don't be busy with material enjoyment. Sukham indriyakam daitya deho yogena dehinam. Sukham indriyakam daitya. This kind of material enjoyment, you can get anywhere. Anywhere, any bird. Those who are, you know, pig, you know, shukar. They also taking nice stool. They think it's enjoyment. So any birth you take, in any birth, you are going to get material enjoyment. So Prahlad Maharaj speaking, any way you can get enjoyment. Don't be busy with enjoyment. Sukham indriyakam daitya deho yogena dehinam. This material life is full of enjoyment. And you are also getting material body. So it's quite natural you can get. Sukham indriyakam daitya deho yogena dehinam sarvatra labbati. Yatha dukkham ayatnataha sarvatra labbati. Everywhere you can get. Irrespective of caste and creed, irrespective of any you go, is one kind of enjoyment. You can get enjoyment, so don't be busy with that. And in Gita, Bhagavan speaking, those who are interested to good material enjoyment, they are actually foolish. Those who are, they are actually not intelligent. Those who are not, they are not intelligent, they are always busy with material enjoyment. They are always busy with material enjoyment. Material enjoyment, they are always busy. So don't be busy with this kind of material. You can get any life you can get. Naham bibhemite oti vayanaka soyu harko netro hukutiravasa gradang stat. This Prahlad Maharaj speaking in front of Nishungade. Naham bibhemite oti vayanaka soyu. Jyohar kanetra bhukuti rabhaswa grudang saad antas rajah khatajo kesar sanka. This way actually Prahlad Maharaj speaking, very nice. Naham vibhemite oti bhayanakasya jyohar kanetra bhukuti rabhaswa grudang saad. He Ajit, naham vibhemite ajito oti bhayanakasya jyohar kanetra bhukuti rabhaswa grudang saad antasrajah kesaro sankukarnat. But ultimately I am fearing this material. It's more fearful. This way actually Prahlad Maharaj one by one giving us lesson, nice lesson. So ultimately actually point is that if we can concentrate on Nishingade, somebody is speaking Srila Bhakti Vimutta Purgeshi Maharaj actually worshipping Nishingadev, he is not having any rasatattva gyan. Somebody speaking. Gurudev smiling. Actually in Brajadham also you can find in front of those coward boys, friends, Krishna manifests Nishingadev avatar in Falengaon. Where from you are going from Kosikala, you know Kosikala? Kosikala one place. From there if you go to towards actually Shergaon. From there you have to go to the place where Obegaon, where Dauji Maharaj doing Rasa Khetra there. While you are going, you can have one spot. I usually go and stay there night time or some for 2 or 3 hours, after that I go. Falengao, its name is Falengao, where Krishna Bhagavan in front of Gopa friends manifests Nishingad avatar. Also that spot is there, you can go and check up. Very nice. Nishingadev appeared. In Nishingapalli actually it is written, I heard from Guru Bhargava, after killing Nishingadev came here to take rest.
Some say he washed his hands
there,
the whole thing.
Yes, here. Took rest here. This place, Orange. Actually, when Mahaprabhu was doing Leela, that time also you can find the name of Nishingananda Brahmachari. You can remember? Who was ready to make all road very soft. Well, Prabhu want to go to Vrindavan. Nishingananda Mojani with meditation speaking, up to that point I could do, through soft flower everything, but after that my mind not going. After Kanai Natsala, my mind not going. This time Prabhu obviously, surely Prabhu not going to Vrindavan. Because I cannot concentrate my mind. Up to Kanai Natsala. It's sure. From Kanai Natsala, Prabhu again come back. That Prabhu is Nishingananda Prabhu, Nishingananda Brahmachari. He used to do bhajan there, in Nishingapalli. You don't know, there is one cave you never seen. Previously, 5-10 years back, five, at least 5 years back also, 5-7 years back, Those pujaris, they used to allow us to cook paramanna. But at present, they don't allow outside people. That time I have seen. When they allow me inside kitchen to cook paramanna, I see there is one cave going inside. But now they don't allow. They make rules difference. Very nice place. Yeah, Hiranyakasipu. Hey, actually, Nisinghananda Brahmachari doing bhajan. Cave. Yeah, in the cave. There. Ah, yes. And Shyamananda Prabhu. Also, you can Shyamsundar Mandir. You can find the cave of. Find the cave of. Actually, Shyamananda Prabhu. Still today, you can see small, small brick. Very cold place. Very nice. You can consider it inside. But actually, they like to have so many noise, they can make problem. Actually, it is not for us. If bonded soul go to a solitary place, it is dangerous. But not for them. Follow what I say. For bonded soul, if they are going to solitary place, they can lose their bhajan. I told you already. This case is not for all. We learn from Guru Bhargava that all the time of the 24 hours we'll have to sing the glories of Supreme Lord, that's all. That is called bhajan. That doesn't mean you cannot concentrate in Harinam. Also we'll have to do Harinam, it's all the same. Bhobad also used to do Satakati Harinam Jagga. It's not for all, they like to concentrate. That time they can meditate and go. With Harinam, they can pass away. Hello, they can pass away. And join their Leela. They are doing Leela, Nitya Leela. This way, actually, there Nisinghananda Brahmachari used to stay there. Because Gaur Leela, actually in Gaur Leela, all different devotees, they get chance. Ram Bhakta also getting chance, Nisinga Bhakta getting chance, it is a mixed, a special Leela, Gaur Leela. Those are Ram Bhakta, they also getting Leela. Anupam and Murari Gupta, they are special Bhakta. Life after death, they are serving. Now why they are going to live? Follow. But still, they join Gauranga Mahaprabhu, they get some special keeper. A special case, actually. Special case, actually. Nisinghananda Brahmachari is doing bhajan. Already getting Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Gauranga Mahaprabhu is actually Nisinghadeva, we say Gaur Nisingo. We say Gaur Nisingo. Gauranga Mahaprabhu in the form of Nisinghadeva there. Prabhupada could saw it from Jokpitsi Mandir. One day, Prabhupada looking, that, oh, actually Nisinghadeva, actually in temple there, na, actually Nisinghadeva, coming here to take paramanna every day. Every day. Gauranga Mahaprabhu Prasad. Every day. There, Jokpit. Nisinghadev coming. Prabhupada could see. First time Prabhu taking trouble to come long way. So better I can establish Nisinghadev here. The Lakshmi Nisingho established from. Follow. Prabhu used to come to take paramanna Prasad. Gauranga Mahaprabhu. So why you are taking trouble, I can establish there. Then Prabhu, our Prabhupada established Nisinghadev here. In Jokpit Mandir, he said, this is Lakshmi Nisingho. For Grihastha, it is Lakshmi Nisingho is good. Ugra Nisingho, you should not keep in at home. Ugra, those who are taggy, they can keep. Those who are staying in home, for them, Lakshmi Nisingho is good, actually. Anyway, you can get, and also you can put some question if you have any question now. Your computer means they are working. My mind is off sometime. He is working there in Gosala. I will have to run. From 6:30 he is working there. I have to go. Any question? No?
Why the Grihastha should not worship
Ugra Nrisingha? Actually this Ugra Nrisingha, actually, Lakshmi Nrisingha is more merciful. That's why. Ugra Nrisingha, actually, if you keep, if you make any mistake, this Guru Maharaj used to say, Ugra Nrisimha, you have to maintain some rules and regulations. All, if you some mistake, big problem. And Lakshmi Nrisimha, mercy. Lakshmi Nrisimha, okay, you can. Jai Jai Lakshmati, Jai Jai Lakshmati, Nrisimha Murari, Mangala Nilaya Prabhu, Amangala Hari. And Nrisimha Dev, the stotra written by that Siddha Sai Pad also. Ugro Pi Anugrevayam Sabaktanang Nikeshwari. This sloka you can speak. You can recite today. Nrisimha Sattva you can. But don't try to use Nrisimhadev for your own purpose. Don't try to give service to Nrisimhadev. That is my request. Usually, those who are so-called devotee, they like to give Nrisimhadev nice seva. Nrisimhadev no employment, so they like to employ, enjoy, engage Nrisimhadev in their own seva. Prabhu, be careful, no danger can come to me. I am going to, there's taxation problem. Prabhu, be careful. A tax officer coming, be careful. This way, Prabhu, some problem took place, he likes to kill me, please save me. This way, some devotees, they are approaching Nrisimhadev, giving paramanna, I am giving warning, Prabhu, I give 20 kg milk paramanna to you, you can remember, previous month, be careful, no problem can touch me. This way, they like to give seva to Nrisimhadev. This is not actually good. If you like to engage Nrisimhadev for your own seva, it's not good. But if you are devotee, automatically you can get protection. Prahlad Maharaj never request in front of Nrisimhadev. Request, but automatically. So actually Nrisimhadev going to protect you, provided you have devotion, automatically. We worship Nrisimhadev mean in the way of our bhajan, if there is any problem, any fighting, any problem, take place, Nrisimhadev always. Because the genuinity should be there inside heart. If there is duplicity, at the same time I like to offer 20 kg paramanno, 40 kg paramanno, Nrisimhadev is less interested about that. Not interested. And another point actually, when Nrisimhadev wanted to give some benediction, you can remember. After Hiranyakashipu was killed, then Prahlad Maharaj repeatedly speaking, Prabhu, Nrisimhadev speaking, that you can take benediction from me. Prabhu, I don't need any benediction. No, Prabhu, you take, actually Nrisimhadev speaking, you must take benediction, I am coming. In front of Prahlad. Prahlad Maharaj saying, I am less interested about benediction. I already get benediction because you come in front of me. What kind of special benediction I can ask? Still you take. Repeatedly when Nrisimhadev is speaking in front of Prahlad Maharaj, then Prahlad Maharaj saying, okay, if you are interested to give benediction, then I am begging one benediction, special benediction from you. What is that? What is that? I already told. No desire should be there. No kama. Kamanam hridisangraho bhavatastu vinevaram. Kamanam hridisangraho bhavatastu vinevaram. I want to get benediction. What kind of benediction? So that no kama can stand. No kama should be there. No kama can stand in my heart. My heart, I like to make it very clear, clean. Follow. This way, Prahlad Maharaj teaching us, when you are having some relation with Nrisimhadeva, Supreme Lord, we should not have any inside desire. We should have any self-interest. It is the main, actually. And for those who are full of karma, for them, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, actually, you can never satisfy, you can never get satisfaction of your sense organ. In your whole life, or next life after life, you cannot get satisfaction of your sense organ. Because Prahlad Maharaj speaking, like scabies, you know, scabies?
Scabies.
Has.
Scratches.
Has. sketching. Scab is called itching one. Some term is there, doctor term, medical term is there. I know actually. So actually, Prahlad Maharaj speaking actually, that if your karma never going to give you satisfaction, there is like one kind of disease it develop, itching. So try to do bhajan nicely, and cut this material bondage and go up. Never try to think that I am doing Raganuga bhajan, I don't need to pray to Nisinga. Not that. Even Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they also pray to Nisinga. To teach us that. Because otherwise how you can, your flawless bhajan should do, that's why. Not that you are going to lose your rasa. Nisinga is going to help you. Eh? Even in Gaurila you can know. Nisingadev, one day Gauranga Mahaprabhu took the two-point club and become Nisingadev and running in Navadvip Road. He's reading Chaitanya Bhagavad, you can go. Gauranga Mahaprabhu running in Nisinga Baba. So everybody running. So this is actually Gaur Nisinga. Follow? So Vancha Kalpataru Sikhi Pasindhubhaya Javatitan Pavanabhyo Vaishnabhyo Namo. What question? Where?
What happened
after that? No, actually, Balavadev, Nisingadev, they are Lilavatar. Lilavatar, it is the duty of Lilavatar, when they come, finish Lila, they will have to go back. So, Balavadev also, you can find one place, Balavantadhan. Here also, Nisingadev came, finally, washing hand and sitting nicely, resting, after that descent. So in the form of deity we find.
So from here he left.
But in the form of deity is there. Everywhere. When Hiranyakasipu was torturing Prahlad Maharaj, you can go through seventh canto. I am not speaking in details. You can find Hiranyakasipu putting Prahlad inside cave. It is called Ahawal Nisingo. When Prahlad Maharaj was thrown into sea ocean from a big hilltop, there you can find Jiyor Nisingo. Special name. It's called Jiyor Nisingo. It's in Vizag. Vizag, you know Vizag one place? Vizag, you don't know? Odisha Purimar, there is Vizag not there. There, actually, Hiranyakasipu throw Prahlad Maharaj through his servant, I mean, those who are Asura, they throw Prahlad Maharaj into ocean. Then Nisingadev catch him. It's called Jiyor Nisingo. When inside cave, Prahlad Maharaj thrown and big stone covering was there. Big Prahlad Maharaj was inside captive hollow. That time, it's called Jiyor Nisingo. Ahawal Nisingo. It's there, you can go in Andhra. In Andhra Pradesh, you are there. You can get darshan. Very dangerous. Ahawal Nisingo, you have to go time to time, come back, otherwise, animal can attract you. Pujari going daytime, quickly come back. It's there. Ahawal Nisingo. And when Prahlad Maharaj was given poison. That is called Parnan Nisingo. Parnan Nisingo is there. There you can, all devotees there offering Sharbat, you know, solution. A special Buga, always Sharbat. Any Sharbat giving? Sharbat, always Sharbat. Sharbat, you know, solution, nice mixture. Sharbat. It's called Parnan Nisingo. That time, when poison was given to Prahlad Maharaj, Prahlad Maharaj speaking to Nisingadev, Prabhu, today we get this kind of, you know, sarbat. You can take. Follow. Then that poison become amrit. Hiranya Kasipu wanted to give poison. He take poison and it become amrit. This way. Like it, this Kali Yuga also, Mirabai was giving snack, very poison, cobra, not cobra, it's called black sack, black snack, you know, Krishna Sarpa, very dangerous. When he opens, the king sending, the speaker is there some fruits. When he open, the cover, he finds snack. They are Mira Giridhari. When speaking Giridhari, he finds there is no snack. Giridhari is there. No snack. When you open, he finds snack. But they fold hand and say, it's Giridhari. Oh, Giridhari. You open eyes and find there is no snack. Snack vanishes. Giridhari is there. So this way, actually. So any more question? It is Nrisimhadev, sometime appears, still today. Like this Gaur Mandal Parikrama Khanda, Barahadev the Brahman in Kolodip, then that Barahadev appeared in Thvantapi. Today also he can appear, Nrisimhadev. But it depends if there is a Nrisimha Bhakta. We are worshipping Nrisimhadev. Ultimately, we are worshipping Gauranga. Follow? We are worshipping Gauranga. We are worshipping Nrisimha, that means Gaur Nrisimha. No problem. So, I am going to get some bumper success in Nrisimhadev. So,
one more question. You mentioned that Prahlad didn't have fear, but as soon as he appeared, Prahlad never had fear, right?
No.
No,
actually, Prahlad Maharaj, when Brahma speaking, Prabhu, actually for you, Prabhu coming. So you have, Prabhu has a great affection, so you can go. If you like that, actually, when Prabhu showing this angry attitude, Nrisimha avatar, but actually inside affection is there. So if Prahlad Maharaj, if Nrisimhadev can find Prahlad Maharaj in front, like you are very angry, when this small girl coming in front of you, your mood can change. Hello, this is the reason. You are very angry. But when you find a small girl crying and coming in front of you, you can change your mood automatically. So Prabhu, now manifesting angry attitude, but in front of Prahlad Maharaj, when looking the face of Prahlad Maharaj, then Nrisimhadev melt up. His heart melt up. And then Nrisimhadev become Lakshmi Nrisimha. Before Ugra Nrisimha. When Prahlad Maharaj coming, talking with Prahlad Maharaj praying stuti, then Nrisimhadev putting hand on Prahlad. After that, Nrisimhadev become very peaceful. Very nice. That is called Lakshmi Nrisimha. So it's quite natural. It's quite natural. For this reason it is written, though one lion is very, very, but if in front of a small baby, lion is very dangerous. In front of lion baby, what lion can do? Lick. Same. Affection. So it's quite natural. So this way actually, Ugro Opi Anugro Vyayam. Though Ugro, but still it is Anugro, not Ugro, in front of devotees. So Vancha Kalpatur Vasikya Basindu Bhavajpati Thanang Pavana Bhavishna Bhyo Namo. So, what time now actually? What is this? What?
Last year, I was not.
Oh, you take this one. It's Ganga Vatar, yeah. But it's better Panchavatra. You take this one. You sit. Om Namaste Narasimha Namaste Jaste Jaste Avira Avira Vayana Kavayana Sukarma Sayana Rande Rande Tumaka Sukasa Om Swaha Abhaya Mahapan Bhishtam Khamiti Om Khamiti Om Khamiti Om Khamiti Om Khamiti Om Khamiti Om Namaste Narasimha Namaste Jaste Jaste Avira Avira Vayana Kavayana Sukarma Sayana Rande Rande Tumaka Sukasa Om Swaha Abhaya Mahapan Bhishtam Khamiti Om Khamiti Om Khamiti Om Namaste Narasimha Namaste Jaste Jaste Avira Avira Vayana Kavayana Sukarma Sayana Rande Rande Tumaka Sukasa Om Swaha Abhayamavatman Huishtam Kramityam Kramityam Kramishnuru Om Sastina Vidvasrabaha Sastina Pushavishavidaha Sastina Astorustanevi Sastina Vihaspati Dadatu Om Ganananta Ganapatiyam Havamahi Om Piyananta Piyapatiyam Havamahi Om Nidhinamta Nidhipatiyam Havamahi Vasamamavidhi Om Santi Om Santi Om Santi Om Sasti 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 Na Vishu Vishu Om Sasti Na Indo Vi Om Sasti Na Vishu Om Sasti Na Indo Vidyasrava Sasti Na Pusha Vishu Vedaha Sasti Na Starkoristanami Sasti Na Vihaspati Dadatu Om Gananam Ta Ganapatiyam Havamai Om Nidhinam Ta Nidhipatiyam Havamai Om Piyanam Ta Piyapatiyam Havamai Vasamo Mahidi Om Santi Om Santi Om Santi Ya Om Santi Jai Nishingodev, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Guru Maharaj, Ki! Yeah.